Hi, my friends. So it is day 30 something, 32 maybe, 33. I don't know. I've gotten kind of tired of counting them, so I should probably write it down. But anyway, it's day 30 something of schedule and life rearranging and all that kind of stuff. And we are doing okay here. My son had a meeting this week with his teacher online. So they've just done like videos back and forth, but today was the first day that they've done a face-to-face online. And I didn't recognize the child that was on there with the teacher because my child, who talks all the time, lots of words, didn't have much to say. Mm-hmm. And then this has kind of consistently been his answer when people say, "So what have you been doing now that you can't go anywhere?" And he says, "I've been watching TV and playing on my tablet." Yep. So, Mom of the Year award, right here. He actually does do other stuff, but that's what he's telling people that he does. So it pretty much sounds like I plop him right in front of the TV while playing a tablet and eating Cheetos. I mean, that's kind of what I think they're envisioning in their head. So, anyway, but none of us are judging each other right now anyway, right? So. We should not be. So I think I mentioned before that it snowed here in Minnesota on Easter, which I was not excited about. And there is still snow outside, which I am not excited about. And here's what I've discovered. I've lived in Minnesota since 2004, so for a while. And I don't think we're good Minnesota people. And I think we're good people. But I don't think we're good Minnesota people. Yeah. I say that because, I mean, it took me a while to like living in Minnesota in the first place. I actually do like it now, by the way. But we don't really take advantage of the Minnesota stuff. For example, did you know that people in Minnesota do things outdoors year-round? True story. Guess who doesn't? Yeah. Pretty much my whole family. We do not do outdoor stuff in the middle of the winter. Or if there's snow on the ground, period. We just don't do it. So I look outside and I see snow and I'm like, well, another day inside, right? But people here, they do things outside. Mm-hmm. They go snowmobiling, which that I actually think would be fun because it looks like jet skiing, which I did in Louisiana a few times. That would be fun. But they do something called snowshoeing, which I think is just like walking in the snow with different shoes on. I'm not really sure. Anyway, they do that. There are people who go skiing, which I've never been skiing. There are people who go sledding, which I've never been sledding. Yeah. And all the kids that I work with at the school are like, "You've never been sledding? That's so, you know, what kind of life have you lived?" But, you know, when you grow up in Louisiana, it's not like there are a lot of opportunities to go sledding. And I didn't move to Minnesota till I was an adult. And now, I mean, I won't say I'm an older adult, but I am an adult who is older than I was when I first moved here. And I don't know. I just can't imagine going sledding as an adult. Because I have a back that doesn't really cooperate all the time, and I have a hip that might fall off at any moment. So I just think if I went sledding, then my hip might end up like on the snow beside me. I don't know. I don't think I'm gonna do it. My kids have been sledding, but that's because somebody else took them. Yeah. So yeah, we don't do that stuff. And then ice skating. I actually have been ice skating. I went ice skating, I don't remember if it was in Marshall, Texas or Jefferson, Texas, when I was in high school, I think. Anyway, I wasn't good at it. And so typically when you're not good at something, you don't really enjoy it. You know, it's not super fun. And then I think one time I might have gone ice skating at the Dallas Galleria mall thing, because they had like an ice rink in the middle. But again, like I held onto the wall the whole time, not fun. So, nobody in my family ice skates. I actually did take Annabelle to ice skating lessons when she was little because she's the first child and you do stuff like that with your first child that you don't do with anybody else. But so I signed her up for these lessons because I had friends that said, "Oh, it's great. It's in this arena and it's warm and it's not warm. Not even a little bit." I walk in, which I should have known because the floor is ice. I mean, but I thought maybe somehow they worked around that, but nope, it's cold. So she's on ice. I'm not on the ice, but I'm standing near the ice. And I'm sitting on a bleacher that feels like ice. So that lasted one round, and we have not done ice skating lessons since then. Because I just don't think we're ice people. True story. Yeah. So I don't do any of that outdoor stuff. Now, people here. Here's what I think happened. I think this might be the history of Minnesota. People moved here when it was like summer. It's gorgeous, and they're thinking everywhere else is hot and it's terrible and muggy. But then they move here and it's beautiful. And then they got here in the winter. And then it started snowing, it got really cold, and then they got scared to leave, right? And they thought they might die if they left, which they probably would have. And so they stayed. And so then they had to come up with this outdoor stuff because they know it's not healthy to stay indoors all year. So that is where I think curling was birthed from. Because curling, I don't really know what it's about, but I do know that there's ice involved. No, thank you. A broom involved. Triple no, thank you. And like a puck or something round, I think. And then they broom it down the ice. I think it's an Olympic sport though, for real. Yeah. Anyway, I don't do curling. So. And there's ice fishing. And people really, it's a thing. They actually do it. So when we first moved here, we were about to move here, and one of Casey's coworkers drove us around town and showed us some stuff, and then they were like, "Oh, let's drive on the lake. That'll be fun." So So they drove us out like just on the shoreline of a lake, and I heard that first little like crunchy layer go crunch, and that was enough for me. So I have not been on a lake since. But people do that here. They drive like full size pickup trucks out on the water, which I think goes against like the laws of nature. But anyway, so they drive them out there, and then there's like this little house that looks kind of like an outhouse from a distance. But supposedly it's warm in there. And I think that might be the version of warm that they said the ice skating lessons were, because you're literally on a frozen lake. That's your floor, is ice. So I'm not sure how that's warm. And if it is warm, then isn't the ice getting warm? I don't know. It doesn't sound like a good idea to me. Anyway, but people go in this house, and then from my understanding, they like drill a hole or somehow get a hole in the ice, which sounds unstable to me. And then they fish. And I don't know if they sleep out there. I'm not sure about that. They might. Anyway, but I don't really fish either, you know? Because as a kid, I thought it was fun, I think. And I used to play with the worms and stuff, but I haven't touched a, I don't touch worms. That's just not something that I do as an adult. And I don't touch like live fish either. So I probably, even if I caught one, I couldn't get it off of the hook. So I'm not a fisher person. And I'm not an ice fisher person for sure. So, but I'm thinking I need to become something. I need to do something Minnesota-ish. We have a fire pit. Fire pits are like really big where we live in Minnesota. So we have one. Now, growing up, we had like a barrel out in the country that we'd burn trash in. But I don't think that's what they mean by a fire pit. So we have, I don't know if we have a fire pit. We have like a ring of rocks thing in our backyard in this house that we've lived in for 5 years. And I think we've used it, I don't know, maybe twice, something like that. Because we don't think to do that kind of stuff, you know? And if I'm going to be outdoors, I don't necessarily want smoke like in my eyes. You know what I mean? Yeah. Decks are really big in Minnesota. We have a deck, We have like a pretty, you know, decent sized deck, but I don't think we utilize it to the fullest extent, you know, because we just don't think to do it. So, I don't know. I just think we're good people. I just don't know that we're good Minnesota people. I don't eat German food. That's kind of a big thing here. I don't eat Swedish food, I don't think. I don't really know what Swedish food is. There's something called lefse that I think might be Swedish, which is like a pancakey kind of thing that you put like butter and sugar on. So if you put butter and sugar on it, it's probably good. I don't know. But I don't make it or really eat it, so I don't know. So I'm wondering, whatever region you live in, what do you do that's regional? Because we don't do Minnesota stuff, and I think we should. I think that's going to be maybe like our quarantine assignment is going to be become Minnesota. I mean, we've lived here long enough. We should be, but I just don't think we're there. I tell you, I think what I could really rock is being a beach person. I could totally rock it living on a beach. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Because that is just right up my alley. I could do that. I would be all over that like white on rice. But Minnesota stuff, I have to get there, you know? People do like to do a lot of outdoor stuff in Minnesota, even when there's not snow on the ground. And, you know, they'll go to like a trail or, you know, something like that. And I mean, we go for walks, but it's like neighborhood walks. I wouldn't typically get in my car and drive to a trail in order to walk. You know what I mean? Like when I can just open up my door and just walk through the neighborhood. So that's kind of what I'm thinking of is, you know, I think we've lived here long enough. We need to just really fully acclimate and do the regional stuff because we don't really do the regional stuff. So let me know where you live. What regional stuff do you do? Because that's going to be my next goal, you know, after my whole house is clean. So I might need to start on being Minnesota before my whole house gets clean, because otherwise I might never do it. Anyway, so that's going to be my next goal in life, is to do Minnesota things, because we live here. So, you know, I think we should. Anyway, that's it for today. Thanks for listening to my ramblings. I love all of you. I really do. And I hope that you are staying safe and healthy and positive during all the craziness. And we're on day 30-something, folks, so we're doing it. So, good luck with everything. I love all of you. Have a good day. Bye.